Hello and welcome to this beginner's guide for the Dark Lord. I should note that this is a live, unscripted guide, so if you hear random stuff in the background, it is what it is, you know, it's live, and the music is just whatever is popular on Spotify at the moment. So before we even get into the boss itself, I'm going to talk a little bit about gear and some account settings and some stuff that you'd want set up before you even want to go in. As this is going to be a melee guide, I'm just going to be focusing on this setup. You're welcome to try other things, but this is just what we're going to use for now. As this is a guide on World 2, you might worry, oh, I don't have all this best and slot stuff. You can grab it from the lectern here, melee presets, max melee. I'm not going to do that because it overwrites anything that you're currently wearing, so don't worry about that. I'm already geared up. Another thing that you're going to want to set up is if you go to the stores and actions under the Vortex hub and then click on action bar options, you can change your presets for your action bar swapping. So my melee bar is bound to bar 1, so if I click bar 1, melee, bar 4, shield. So what that does is if I equip my shield, it automatically swaps to my defensives, and then if I equip my offhand, it automatically swaps back. This just makes life a hell of a lot easier, and it's just going to make the kill a lot smoother overall. As far as gear, I'm just using, you know, the best in slot stuff. If you have a defense cape or a max cape variant or a comp cape variant, you want to put the defense cape in it or wear the defense cape. If you see here, if I examine it, it's going to tell me that the defense cape is added. This acts as a sign of life so that you don't need to bring one in your pocket slot. Now, normally I would bring a scrimshaw, but for the sake of teaching, and most people aren't going to have a scrimshaw when they actually do it on World 1, I'm not going to bring one. Now, as far as getting to the boss itself, normally you would go through this dark portal here, or if you went to the max guild portal, which is similar to the one at home, is over here. However, if you are max, you should probably know that. Right. So as far as using the max guild portal at home on World 2, you want to attune it or retune it and select the Dark Lord here. And now you will have the option to go into it. So before we actually go in, I'm just going to talk briefly about why I have everything I have. The shield, obviously for defensives. Overload, just best in slot bonuses. Weapon poison, because yes, both the boss and the minions are able to be affected by poison. Steel Titan and Scrolls, just because I want as much damage as possible. You can bring a Yak when you're learning, especially if you're not comfortable with using defensives like Resonance, but I'm going to be using a Titan for this playthrough. I'm also going to be using Summoning Flasks, just to make my use of the Steel of Legends even easier. I'm not going to worry too much about being super efficient with these for the sake of the tutorial, but obviously if you want super super fast and very consistent kills, you're going to bring these with you. Ring of Vigor, obviously just nice to have for your ultimates. Now, Adrenaline Potions. You can use them on phase 1. I would just be very careful about using them on phase 2, depending on when you time it. It is very tempting to use them after your Berserk, so that you can get to your thresholds quickly, but you want to hold on to it because it will likely save your life on the final phase if you're not properly prepared, or even if you are and you're just having a little bit of trouble. Brews, just for panic combo eating, and restores, I mean prayer, and also you do have the overload, so you don't need to worry too much about restoring a brew, but yeah, always good to have them. I'm going to be using the vampirism aura. Now, it should be noted that this boss is a glass cannon. You don't need to worry about accuracy auras, you don't need to worry about bringing a Guthic staff or a Eustatius Warhammer or anything like that. Just purely you versus the boss, you don't need to worry about hit chance. Right, now so when we enter the portal we have five options here. The first is a normal fight. This is what I'm going to be using for the tutorial. The second is join encounter. You can join an existing fight as long as they have not started the fight yet, but they're through the portal, and I'll go through that in a little bit. There is a practice mode encounter, which is basically the same as the normal, however, all the damage you take from the boss is halved, as well as I believe the minions. However, there is no loot at all granted at the end. If you are struggling to get a kill on the normal mode, perhaps give the practice mode encounter a go, but I'm not going to be doing that for now. Right. Hard mode is a step up from the normal encounter. This will have additional mechanics and an additional phase. We are not going to worry about that for this because this is a beginner's guide. And finally, there is a kill count just because this is a custom boss, so there isn't a kill count displayed anywhere on the interface. Right. First thing, once you get into the cave, you will notice that there is a chest, and you'll also notice the boss is here. Don't worry, the boss isn't going to immediately hit you. It's not going to start the fight without you being prepared. This is just a lobby for your team to get ready. You know, if you're waiting for people to come in, you're waiting to build adrenaline, you need to bank, or for example, I can summon the Titan here, and then I can bank, and then I can get an additional piece of food out. It should also be noted that with the Titan, if you left click on the special move, you can enable always use special. This is basically like revolution for your familiar. So as long as you do have special move points and you do have scrolls in your inventory, it will just constantly use the special over and over again. This is really nice. As this is a beginner's guide, I will also be using the revolution combat mode just for my general abilities. Although as you become more experienced and understand the boss a bit more, you can swap to full manual. As this is a melee guide, I'm going to just be sitting on the Lunar spellbook. You could also do this with ranged. With magic, it is a little bit more complicated because you need to be using spellbook swap, but just for the sake of a melee guide and for a beginner's guide, we're going to stick on the Lunar spellbook. The reason for this, now this isn't compulsory, but it's going to make your life a hell of a lot easier, is the Disruption Shield ability, and also Vengeance or Group Vengeance if you are in a team. Now to initiate the fight, you would talk to the boss. Don't worry, it's not going to immediately attack you. You would say yes here, and the boss will be waiting for you down in the arena. Now, it should be noted that once this has started, no new teammates can join the arena, as well as you cannot leave, and you can no longer use the bank chest. Right, now, these steps is how you will initiate the fight. The first person who goes down will be the designated tank, unless someone provokes them off. I'll just briefly go through the mechanics before I go down, just because it'll all happen quite quickly and there isn't really enough time to properly explain it. So the Dark Lord has a very, very predictable attacks pattern. It's not like a Raxor where there's like elements of randomness. It's always going to be the same. So you can have three auto attacks. Now these auto attacks are going to be either ranged damage if you are not in the boss's melee range, or the magic damage if you are in the boss's melee range. So as this is a melee kill, I will primarily be camping Protect from Magic, or Deflect Magic rather, on the Ancient Curses prayer book. So after the first three auto attacks, it is going to be the minion's special attack. So on phase 1 and on phase 2, it is minions, meteor shower, force push, and then repeats back. So three auto attacks special, three auto attacks special. The minions is just two minions spawning per person, so just be aware that the boss fight does scale as well as its health, so it's going to be 150,000 per phase per person. The minions is going to be one minion spawning by the boss and one minion spawning by you. However, obviously, if I am meleeing the boss, they're basically going to spawn on me anyway. These minions don't do anything special, they just melee you. However, I would still keep Prey Magic on just because the boss does hit harder than the minions. In a group, it is a good idea, if you're using melee at least, to all stand on top of each other and then use AoE abilities like Flurry, Quake, Hurricane, etc. Now, as this is a very basic guide, I'm just going to be using Dual Wield. I'm not going to be bringing a two-handed switch, so I'm not going to be using Quake and Hurricane. But we don't need to worry about that too much. Even if the flurry does not kill the minions, don't panic, don't get off the boss, don't start attacking them. We'll deal with them in a little bit. So once the minions have spawned, the boss will do its next three auto attacks, and then the next special, the meteor shower, will show up. Now the meteor shower will drop bombs where your characters are currently standing, so you can physically move out of the way, and there are going to be two bombs per person, increasing by one each phase. So on phase 2, there's going to be 3 bombs per person, and on phase 3, 4 bombs per person. It should be noted that these bombs do splash damage, so you need to be super careful about where you stand, because if you're standing near another person, or you're running into the path of where they were standing when a bomb dropped, you could get hit. So, all memes aside, you don't really want to PK your teammates, especially if you're near the end of a kill. It's such a feels bad if you're gonna have to reset just because someone fucked up. Now, as well as hitting your teammates, the bombs can hit both the boss and the minions, and the bombs do a base damage of 3500, although each successive bomb that hits the boss will do 500 more each time. Once you get much more experience with a team, you can do strategies like standing on two opposite sides of the boss and using, with the shield on, the reflect ability as well as the debilitate ability, so that you take significantly reduced damage from the bombs, but the boss takes a lot of damage. This is going to be super helpful, but I wouldn't recommend it just while you're learning. One thing you can start to do when you're learning, though, is when the minions spawn and you're attacking it, use the flurry ability and then don't worry about if this fully kills the minions. Wait for the bombs to spawn, and then as soon as you see it starting to fall, click away, and the bombs will land on the minions and hopefully kill them. Alright, I'm just moving around to give you a better view of the arena. The third mechanic, after the bombs, is the force push. So, let's say I was standing over here, and the boss was going to push me. It will push me back 10 tiles and stun me, and do 4500 melee damage to me. This is a flat amount, so your armor is not going to reduce it at all. If you get pushed into a wall, you get further stunned and take even more damage, and I believe the damage is typeless when you hit the wall. To mitigate the push, you can use the anticipation ability or the freedom ability, but you have to have these active before you get pushed. Then to mitigate the damage, you want to use the resonance ability. You could also use the disruption shield ability, or if you don't have time because you didn't count the auto attacks correctly, you could just use anticipation and then activate protect from melee to take half damage from the punch. The most important thing is not being pushed, so if you can only pick between resonance and anticipation, I would usually take the anticipate because you can flick on deflect melee and you don't need to worry about global cooldown for that. Now, it should be noted that while the punch is aimed at the main base tank, anyone who is like directly in front of the boss in a cone will also get pushed. So you need to, like, if you're not wanting to get punched or if you're not prepared to do resonate the hit, you do not want to be standing near the base tank for that. All right, I'm going to head down and don't forget my aura and start this off, and I will talk over it as I'm doing it. So try to follow along. Okay, I'll start the timer. So as you'll notice, I'm in melee distance, so I'm taking magic hits. Okay, so the minions have spawned. So I need to get to 50%. And then I'm going to use the flurry ability. Oh. I have quite bad ping because of where I am, compared to the server, but that is okay. Alright, then I'm going to anticipate, I'm gonna wait for this to hit me, and then use the resonance ability, and I'm not even being hit at all. Now you should also notice that the boss does say the chat above his head when he does something, and he also says it in the chat here. So come forth my children is going to be the next one. So wait here, come forth my children, and that signals for you to use flurry. And then when I see the bombs, it'll say, let the skies rain down upon you. I'm going to move out of the way. And the bomb is going to hit the minions and the boss. Should be noted that it does also hit your familiar. With a Nile, this is a problem, but for anything else, it's not really a problem. Like a Yak or a Titan. So if you can get the resonance mechanic down, I mean, like, I'm not even eating food. The only thing I'm using is Superstore. I don't have a scrimshaw on. I'm just using Vampirism Aura. Okay, now, as we are coming up to the end of the phase, it is important to not kill the boss here. So I need to actually get the boss off, because if I kill the boss, or rather, if I phase the boss while there are minions alive, this can get me killed. So I'm just going to kill these, and I'm going to wait until he does his push. and then I'm gonna phase him. Perfect. Alright, so in between phases, the boss is going to heal. So I'm going to use Disruption Shield here. And this is going to prevent there is a big hit in between the phases. And you do not want to take that. Alright, so on phase 2, the single minion is replaced by a big minion. Now this minion has an adrenaline bar, but you don't have to worry about a second one. I have killed the minion, now I'm going to use freedom. I'm not actually being damaged, but you can use freedom to remove the bleeds. Alright, and then I'm going to get my resonance off. And that's going to heal me. So, when the big minions get to 50% adrenaline, they will use a bleed attack. And that can hit everyone in the room. They can use all of the bleeds, so dismember, slaughter... I think is it combust and fragmentation? So you need to be aware of that. You can use freedom to remove the bleeds. But they're pretty easy to kill. Right, so I've been bled here, but it's not hitting me, so I'm not gonna freedom it. Now I'm moving a little bit too far. So the bombs weren't hitting the boss. There we go. Easy. And look, I'm on phase two, I'm not even using food. Super easy. So one other thing, oh yeah, I need to use Vengeance. Just use Vengeance whenever you can. I used Slaughter, but I think I walked it, so it's fine. Okay, I need to move. Is that gonna kill the minion? No, not quite. And then I'm just gonna heal up with Resonance. Easy. Oh, now. I need to get off. And I'm going to get my minion to... My minion. My familiar to attack this. The reason being, I do not want the minion to be alive when I phase the boss. Because it is going to... You see with the bleeds? Oh, I need to heal out of that. Oh, that was early. Luckily it hit a zero. But you can see what I did wrong there. Now, I do not want a minion to spawn because otherwise, if I try to use the Disruption Shield ability and the minion is alive, it could potentially, like with a bleed or even just with a melee hit, it could take it and then you will take a very large hit. I believe going from phase 2 to phase 3, it is a 9,000. Alright, so on phase 3, we have to deal with two small minions and a large minion per person. This is very rare, this almost never happens, but it should be noted that if the minion does somehow manage to get to... Oh, I should probably be on Prim Magic again. When I get back in here. If the minions do somehow manage to get to 100%, any health they have left over is healed. They'll die and they'll give that health left to the boss. Now, you will have noticed that I have put on my shield and I have used immortality. There is a fourth special attack added on phase 3 after the punch, and this is the insta-kill mechanic. So what you need to do is you need to use immortality and you need to stand inside this water, and this will save you. If you get immortality on, but you don't manage to stand inside the water, you will die and the immortality will not save you. So you just need to keep that in mind. Oh, I need to freedom that. Okay, so this is a tough situation, so I'm going to use reflect because I cannot guarantee that I am able to live. Right. So I need to be building up to 100% here, so this is where an adrenaline potion could come in handy. I'm not going to worry about it too much. Oh, by the way, if you attack the boss in this... Okay, maybe I will need to use it. Oh, that's going to be close. That was very close there. I think I may have had my revolution set to trigger thresholds because I automatically used destroy and I did not mean to. There we go, there's my sign of life popped. Oh jeez, this is turning very quickly into a difficult situation. Okay, I need to somehow get 100% adrenaline. I may lose the kill here. Nope, I got it. So I'm just going to ignore the minions here, and I'm just going to try and DPS down the boss as quickly as possible. Oh, I did not mean to change target there. And when the boss dies, the minions die too. Then what will happen is you will be able to climb up the steps on the other end, and a chest will appear. You can then open the chest and loot it. Now, I managed to get an onyx, some ascendry bolts, rune ore, and some ancient bones. These ancient bones are used to upgrade and also create scrimshaws. Incredibly helpful. You can just bank all, exit, and you can go right in through the portal here again if you wish to rejoin. You could then bank and set up another kill. Something else that you may want to do is you can unlock this crate from the tutorials in the Lumbridge Combat Academy, and you could drop a dummy here for your team to build adrenaline on. Now, I'm not going to do another kill, but as you can imagine, starting on 100% adrenaline could be very beneficial. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments for me, and I will do my best to answer them. Anyway, take care.